Which collagen supplement is better for your skin? This? Or this? Two are bovine derived, and one is fish derived. Neither are vegan. The Vital Proteins is bought from Costco, and it is $36.99 for 24 ounces. Both say they are grass-fed, but only one says that it is pasture-raised. Now, the reason why this is a point of differentiation for some of you, it won't even matter to you, is because all calves are raised eating grass. And then at a certain point, the ones that are not organically grown are not pasture finished, meaning they get moved on to grains, so they get fatter faster. When they are pasture raised, that means that the entire time they're not grain fed by any GMO corns, they are completely raised on grass, which means it takes longer for them to get fattened up, which means it costs more. So ultimately, at the molecular level, the collagen may be healthier, it may not be, I'm not really sure. But for those of you who really, this is important to you, it does actually say that it's pasture raised. Now, I'm not saying that the Nutracollagen is not pasture raised, it just has said that it is grass fed. But all calves, when they're eating, after they're weaned off the milk, they are all fed grass initially. So the price difference for the Nutracollagen Keto Collagen is $45.99 for 17.6 ounces. And like I said, this one is, the Costco price was $36.99, and that was for 24 ounces. Now, I do want to show you that they're both keto, and this one is paleo friendly. So this contains the fatty acids from the coconut oil, the MCT, which stands for medium chain triglycerides. Now, most foods actually contain the long chain triglycerides. And how this is beneficial for skin is that it contains fatty acids that help inhibit yeast and bacteria growth. So for those of you who have persistent fungal acne or some kind of fungal infection on your skin, this can be beneficial, ingesting this and having this a part of your diet. So if you look at the texture looks more like a coffee creamer. So this is not just the collagen supplement that's in here. This is actually a protein powder. Now this one is vanilla, and it actually smells really like a vanilla ice cream almost, or like a vanilla cookie. So compared to the protein powder, if you've never seen collagen supplement powder before, it's usually a very fine milled white lighter powder compared to the creamer like texture. To point out with this is I made this with the marine collagen, and you'll notice that it's really frothy. So I wanted to do it without the protein shake, so you would see it'll be really frothy if you do it with just collagen. But if you do it with the keto collagen, the texture is a lot creamier. Okay, so this one here is going to be with the keto collagen. Not as frothy, a little bit more creamy. Now let's take a look at all three labels. As you can see carefully, glycine is the highest on all three. Glycine is an amino acid that is actually needed to make protein, creatine, and collagen. But it's also needed in the aid to make antioxidant in our bodies called glutathione. I do want to point out that just because a specific product has the most of a certain ingredient, it doesn't necessarily mean that it is the best, because whatever your body doesn't absorb, whatever excess there is, you're going to excrete. There are some people who are larger and want to get larger muscles, they're gonna want more of a certain type of amino acid over another. If you're a smaller person like me, you're not gonna need as much. So the next one I want you to focus on is the glutamic acid, which aids in better sleep. It actually promotes better immunity and a healthier gut. So the Nutracollagen's Keto Collagen had one ingredient labeled that the other ones did not, and that is cysteine. And cysteine actually helps in the production in glutathione. So that is one of the body's natural antioxidant. Now, when I started taking the Keto Collagen, I actually stayed fuller a lot longer, and that is because it does have the medium chain triglycerides. Now, if you notice by looking at the marine collagen, it consistently is a lot lower than the bovine derived, the vital proteins and the keto collagen is. However, one of the benefits of the marine collagen is that it has more of the type 1 collagen, which primarily helps with the skin. I had a viewer ask if the taking collagen supplements actually helps, and the answer is yes. Clinical studies have shown that when taking collagen supplements as a part of a regular diet, it has shown significant improvements in the joints, as well as reducing the inflammation, so they have less aches and pains, improvement in the appearance of the skin, hair, and nails, and overall health. Now, I will say this, the clinical studies that I did look at, it was actually a nutraceutical, it was a cocktail of collagen supplements along with vitamins and minerals that were mixed into this supplement. So when they did this test and showed overall improvement, I will say that it was taken both together with that. So it may show some beneficial improvement when taking with that. Along with it, I'm sure there's still some significant improvements as well. And the viewer asked on the second part of it, if I stop taking these supplements, will my skin go back to the way that it was? So anytime you see improvements that you're doing something regular and then you stop doing that, my answer is yes. Probably the improvements with your hair, your nails, your overall health, and your joints probably will go back if you reduce significantly the amount of collagen that you are ingesting. If you want more videos that combine the nutrition of food and how it affects the skin, please give us a thumbs up and put it in the comments below. If you want to find out more about glutathione, then I'll see you in this next video. Remember, makeup is an art, skincare is a science.